of me when you are all alone. Maybe, maybe, maybe.
There's a plant that every school kid knows, and every forager should know. One of the more common plants and edibles is the dandelion. You recognize the little flower here, and when it goes to seed, it'll do that little poof ball that you can blow all over the yard. There, you can see it's starting to do it here. Now, look at the leaf structure. It's again your in-out, in-out, kind of like a mustard, if you will. Like I say, this is a very noticeable form, and something you should always be looking out for. And the flowers themselves, when they're yellow, you can make an alcohol out of, a beer of some sort. I gotta try that one day. The young leaves, like this one, are good for salad. Actually, it's still a little bit bitter. That just means it needs to be a pot herb instead. But nothing some salad dressing can go cover. The root can be pulled up, parched, and turned into a chicory. Let's see. Probably have to do a stab on the sides here. I only got some of it. This goes down much further. But this can be parched, turned into a chicory, which is a good extender for your coffee, or if you don't have coffee, it's got some natural stimulants. I don't think it's actually caffeine, probably B vitamins and whatnot. So it's good for the morning too. You can actually boil the root and eat it. It's not bad tasting, but I prefer it as my morning tea, if you will. Now the older leaves you can use as a pot herb, and they're called collard greens. You may have heard that before. Absorbs the taste of any meat you put in there and ends up really good. Now this grows pretty much everywhere, so you should have some in your yard because, this was a staple in the kitchen up until about 60 years ago. That's part of why it grows everywhere. We used to grow it in our front yard, and it's adapted to every terrain that humans live in. I've actually done a video on mustards before. The only reason I'm showing you this one is because this is probably some of the best mustard plants I've ever tasted. So for those of you in Colorado, your mustard plants are, almost too spicy. These young ones on the top of the stem, dead on like mustard, and a really spicy mustard. After about two or three leaves, I gotta stop. But it would go great in anything and give it that mustardy taste. So if you're in Colorado, the best damn mustard plants I've ever had. Now, the more you get into foraging, the more you'll start recognizing plant structures. This looks kind of like amaranth, kind of like dock. We can't positively identify it, so we're not going to eat it. But because it looks familiar, we're going to get some pictures and video of it, and then tonight we'll go research it. If it's edible, we'll find out, and even if it's not edible, most plants have uses. So, it'll be another plant in the bag of tricks. So we're gonna pay attention to all the little details. Got a nice long seed bud, kind of like amaranth or dock. Alternating leaves. A little bit peluso. You see what I mean? Looks very much like a dock without the red stem, kind of like amaranth, only the underside isn't shiny gray. So, a little bit of research tonight and we'll have a new plant that we know. Even if it's not edible, most plants have use. Though I bet that this has some sort of edible parts just because it looks like the cousins that we all know.